time we open up shop, isn't it?
Good morning. How are you? Welcome. You look great. That's a nice shirt you got there. Are you the sheriff in town today?
Here we go.
You going to help us out? Because we got some varmints in town. I believe so.
Thanks, babe.
Oh, man.
Maybe we
got to
go to the blacksmith. Maybe we got to get that food from the blacksmith.
Hi, Mom. How
you doing?
We ended up on its own.
Welcome, welcome one and all to Calico. I am the Honorable Judge Roy B. Quiet! Now you listen here, Kid Friday. Just because I don't agree with you being the Mayfield's gang's lawyer, that don't give you the right to expurge my name in front of all these good people here.
Well, Miss Merchant, I'm just telling how I see it. I mean, those boys, they just needed someone in this town to make sure they had a fair trial, and that's what I've done.
What you done was take a group of ne'er-do-wells charges and getting them dismissed on a technicality. Now, you stop interrupting me while I talk to these nice people here, or that bathtub of yours is liable to spring a few leaks. You got that? Get back in here.
All right.
Now, where was I? Oh, yes. Now, for a few words, right now.
Are you okay?
That's the first ride in town. Now, for a few words on this, the anniversary of the founding of our town of Calico, I'd like you to welcome our mayor. Here he is, Horton Parnell. Give him a hand.
No more gunfire, okay? No more gunfire. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, it is an honor and a privilege to be welcoming all of you newcomers to our fair town on this, our 77th Founders Day! All right. We get your enthusiasm. Now, friends, I have prepared a small speech.
Now, Mayor, don't you think it'd be right if Peg Leg gives the welcome since he found the nugget?
Come on now, Zeke, that's okay. Let the mayor be. This doesn't concern the assay office. That's all right.
All right, come on now, Zeke. Listen to Peg Leg. Let the mayor handle all this, all right?
Yeah, but, you know, he needs some respect that's due him. In fact, that nugget put Calico on the map.
What are you talking about, putting Calico on the map? You don't know what you're talking about.
Fire in the hole!
Where'd
you get that?
Sorry, I'm sorry. Now, it's true that Peg Leg finding the largest nugget on record in Calico County has brought a lot of new citizens to town. And it is also true that that you and your daughter have bought the deed to Calico. Now, with all that aside, let's put aside any differences we might have for today and concentrate and celebrate those who had the courage and foresight to settle this land, all right?
Yeah!
Okay, now, Abigail Dynamite is the chair of the Founders Day Event Committee, and she's going to tell us all the goings-on today.
This is going to be the greatest Founders Day ever. We have got lots for a body to do today. Well, we've got pony racing, a shooting competition, a whiskerino contest. Well, heck, we even have bingo. Oh, and of course, our annual town hoedown.
So what you want to do is make sure you go over to the Miners Bank of Calico and check out Peg Leg's Nugget.
And there are times and schedules where all these contests are taking place at the town hall, the post office, and here at the assay office.
Not today. The printer forgot to print them.
Okay. Let's put that aside now. It is now time for I, Horton Parnell, the mayor of Calico, to welcome you and hereby commence these commencements. Commenced! Yeah! Welcome to Calico, everybody!
Why is the day we let my father out of jail?
I ain't forgot. As a matter of fact, I never thought I'd say this, but
maybe kind of sad to see you go, Ox. You've been quite the model prisoner.
I appreciate that, Bryce. Thank you so much. I'm just going to take my guitar and leave, man.
Wait a second, Mr. Ox. You still have 15 minutes and 38 seconds.
All you did was you made yourself quite the time. You better keep this job with the Pony Express.
Right, I'll have you know I didn't lose my job. Mr. Quint from the post office got me this one right after he bought the Pony Express.
Yeah, and then there's a law against a business buying up the property of another, right?
That's right.
What? You said a mouthful. Seems there's no law in this town that stops anybody from buying up what rightfully belongs to somebody else.
Yeah.
Ain't that right, Peg Leg?
What are you trying to say, Clay?
I'm saying that somebody bought up a thing that belong to somebody else. I won't say exactly what that is. My point is, my father is due to get out of jail.
Well, still in about 12 minutes.
All right. Well, I'm trying to figure out exactly why it is that this man owns a deed that has my father's name on it.
Well, that's because your family was incarcerated and my best friend Pegleg struck it rich, y'all!
Yeah!
Clay, can't we have one Founders Day when you and your boys don't come into town stirring up all this trouble for the good citizens of this town?
We ain't causing no trouble, Judge. We just aiming to get back what's ours.
Yeah.
We want to know how the mayor was able to sell something that wasn't his to sell in the first place.
Yeah! Well, it's because Pegleg struck it rich, like I said.
Somebody ought to unstruck him rich. What? You know what I mean.
Now trust me. Somebody tries to steal Peg Lake's fortune out of that bank almost every day. Well, all right, let's get this over with. Ox, looks like you served your time for unlawful commandeering of train contingent 41.
Sheriff, you still have 7 minutes and 14, 13, 12.
All right. Well, I'm letting him out of jail early for good behavior.
Yeah!
Highly unrealistic.
Maybe not. You're free to go, Ox.
I appreciate
that. Good luck to you. Well, Ox, you're a free man now. So what are you going to do now?
I'll tell you what he's going to do. I'll tell you what we're all going to do. With the help of our lawyer here, we're going to get that deed back.
Lawyer? He ain't no lawyer. Oh, I see he's wearing his legal briefs.
You know as well as I do that Saturday is my bathing day. Now, it's true. I ain't a real lawyer yet, but I have 2 correspondence courses left to go with my studies with the Honest Abe Law School. And these boys here, they just want what's rightfully coming to them is all.
They're going to have to take that up with the mayor over at Town Hall.
Then that's just what we'll do. Come on, folks. We're headed to Town Hall to get back what's rightfully ours.
Yeah.
All right, folks. All right. Enough of these distractions.
Clay Mayfield, what's going on?
Well, my father has just been released from jail after serving his time for stealing Engine 41, and he's here to claim what's lawfully his. He wants the deed back, Horton.
No, now listen here, Clay. That deed became property of Town Hall when you and your boys were arrested for stealing it.
Well, excuse me, Mrs. Parnell, but I think I was able to prove without a doubt that Ox and his family were falsely accused. Now, they weren't robbing the bank. They were merely taking what was theirs out of the vault. As you remember, nothing but the deed was taken out of that vault during the robbery, or the non-robbery, as it were.
Yeah, how you can lead to a jury, I will never know.
That's good, right? Listen, now, if y'all would just hand over what's mine, I would appreciate it.
Well, we don't have it. It belongs to Peg Leg and Ophelia Cinch. It became theirs when they bought it.
I see. And what became of the profits from said sale?
Yeah, good question. That's a nice diamond stick pin you got there, Mayor.
Well, thank you.
Well, you see here, you're not implying to these good people that the mayor and our staff have used those funds for our own advantage.
You're right, girl. I'm not implying it. I'm just saying it.
How dare you take what is ours?
Yes. we know that my mother, Phyllis Mayfield, was one of the founders of this town.
That's actually a questionable statement. Though Phyllis Mayfield, yes, did play an important role in the history of this town, she ain't actually one of the founders.
Excuse me, if Phyllis Mayfield ain't a town founder, who is?
Well, we don't know.
wait a minute. You mean to tell me that every year we celebrate Founders Day and we don't know of whom we are celebrating?
Yeah, that's sort of the long and short of it.
Sweet irony, yeah, what that girl said.
Our new clerk is not here. Would you go get the town record, please?
Yeah. Oh, that's right. You have a new clerk.
Oh, yes. You see, y'all, we had to replace Miss Elsie. Poor thing succumbed to a snake bite at a church sociable.
God rest her soul!
What are you, a bunch of ministers?
The names of the original settlers, they're illegible. All right? So that means they've been damaged and they're not clear.
Well, I can be perfectly clear. A deed to the land that this town sits on was given to me by my late wife. And y'all took and hid it from us, and now you've sold it out from under us. So, mark my words, come hell or high water, hell. I'm gonna get that deed back. Let's go, boys. We got some plotting.
All right. Now, folks, listen. Let's not let any of the usual Mayfield nonsense ruin our Founders Day, all right?
Yeah!
Folks, please, pay no never mind to the notion that somehow your political leaders have profited from the sale of the town deed. I mean, that's just hogwash.
That's right.
Now, folks, don't forget, one of our first Founders Day competitions is about to begin right here at 10:40. Now, we're going to have a hoop and stick relay race right here in front of the old schoolhouse. And, of course, everybody is invited to come on out and participate. So, we'll see y'all right here in just a few minutes.
Now, get out there and celebrate our town and our Founders Day.
Yay!
Happy Founders Day, everybody!
All right, folks, this is the man's right here, this girl.
Look at Greg.
Phyllis.
That's funny, because I didn't think you was doing either of those things.
You know, Ox, it was never becoming a you to lie, and it still isn't.
What brings you to town, Phyllis?
It's been a long time for us too, Phyllis.
Shut up, Ox. Now, folks, join us over at the town hall where Port will officially open the gift from the governor. Come on, everybody, let's go to town hall.
Ladies and gentlemen of Calico, I give you the mayor of our fine town, Mr. Horton Parnell.
Well, thank you, Kenny, and thank you, folks. This has been an exciting day, and it's going to get better. Earlier today, Quint over at the post office received a telegram from the governor letting us know he was sending over a gift to celebrate our 77th year as a township, and here it is! All right, I have selected one fine citizen to help with the opening of this gift. Ladies and gentlemen, I introduce you, Ember, everybody!
Using these newly discovered artifacts.
Oh. I second that. I second that. in that motion, and I think that's a great idea. Now, I'd be happy to head up a group of concerned citizens to solve this mystery. In the meantime, we're going to store these things in town hall, okay?
All right, sounds good. Now, folks, don't forget, now, another one of our Founders Day competitions is about to take place now at 12:40. We're going to have our volunteer fire department is going to be holding a bucket brigade race. So make sure you see y'all down at the fire wagon at 12:40, all right?
Thank you all for joining us. Happy Founders Day, everybody! Miss Phyllis, I don't think this is the time nor the place.
Actually, I think it's the perfect time, considering it involves everybody. All right, now, I know I haven't had the most shining of reputations, so I'm sure you all are wondering why I've come back into town after all this time. Well, I've finally come to collect what's mine. Now, sitting in a security box in that bank down yonder is the deed to the land that you all are standing on, and that deed belongs to me.
Well, actually, it's not in the bank anymore.
What happened to it?
You should have said that.
I thought you were dead.
God rest your soul.
Stop doing that.
I thought you was deceased, Phyllis, so as your next of kin, I crossed out your name on the deed and wrote in my own name.
Hand it back, Ox.
Well, he doesn't have it. The town took it when we got incarcerated, and they sold it to a prospector named Pegley.
Boo! Now, you have no right to sell my land. That deed is mine.
Yeah.
I do want it back.
Well, I'm afraid that ain't gonna happen because, you see, we sold that deed at a time when your family was incarcerated.
But she wasn't. Wait, now. Now, hold on. Let me get this straight. You all lost my property, and you all sold it? Well, now, I don't think I need to remind you that I've been known to have quite a temper.
Oh, yeah.
And let me assure you, I'm not happy. So let me tell you how this is gonna work. I'm thirsty from a long train ride. So I'm gonna go to that saloon and get me a drink while you all get my deed back. And if I don't have that piece of paper in my hand in 2 hours, well then my boy and I, we're gonna take it back.
Uh-oh.
Understood?
Yes, ma'am. This is really exciting.
Yeah. Mama needs a drink. 2 hours.
Folks, don't worry. I'll talk to her and see if we can't come to some kind of compromise.
Yeah, don't worry. I'll talk to her, too.
Difficult case for me to try.
I think you need to know this, that the accused here, Phyllis Mayfield and myself, had a bit of a past. You see, at one time, yes, at one time, we were in love.
Oh.
Yeah, that was long before she met up with the likes of Ox Mayfield. And back before she took up a life of crime. But I promise you folks, and I promise you, Phyllis, that I will judge this case fairly and honestly and to the best of my ability.
I appreciate that, Roy.
I am sure. All right, you two have heard the charges against you. How do you plead?
All right, now, Judge, you're looking at two people who've made mistakes. We've both done things we ain't proud of. We've lied, cheated, stop that. And we've stolen. And yes, we've even robbed a bank or two. But that's in our past. We're no longer those people no more. I came into town to get what's rightfully mine. I came to get my deed. That's all I want. I just want what's due me. So, Your Honor, we plead not guilty.
You know what? This case is a lot more difficult than I thought it was going to be. And I can't decide this on my own, so I'm going to leave this in the hands of the people of Calico. So, good citizens of Calico, you've heard their plea. How do you find them? Guilty or innocent?
Guilty!
Innocent!
That's right. I heard the verdict. It was guilty. Quiet! I'm in charge here. As much as I hate to do this, I am going to have to sentence you two to 5 years in the Calico Jail. Order! 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 Do you have anything to say for yourselves?
Yes! We're innocent!
Sheriff, take him away.
No, wait, stop.
Hold it, everybody, listen up.
Wait, stop. Phyllis is right. They're innocent.
What are you talking about, Zeke?
Well, they didn't rob any bank. They didn't steal that nugget.
Zeke, how do you know that?
Because I did.
What?
I stole the nugget.
Why on earth would you do something like that?
Well, because that... Ever since, I've held this secret ever since that nugget was found, and that if I figured if it went away, so would the secret. That nugget and all the other nuggets around town, they're pyrite.
What?
They're fool's gold.
Fool's gold?
Yeah, I lied. You know, not because I wanted to be rich. I saw what it did for the people, the effect it had on the town. Everybody had hope, and I don't have that in me to go around dashing folks' hopes and dreams. So I broke into the bank, and I got rid of the nugget.
That can't be true, Zeke.
It is true, Peg Leg. You know, that Calico mine is actually a silver mine.
What?
Silver mine?
Yeah, that's why you haven't had much luck for so long.
All right, listen up. Sheriff, release these two. And Zeke, I'm afraid I'm going to have to lock you up, although I don't know what I'm going to charge you with. Deputy, get ready to put Zeke inside the jail cell.
Bryce, hang on, Bryce.
I'm so sorry, everybody.
Hold it.
Bryce, just let me go in his place.
No.
What?
Wait,
what? Is something in the water we should be concerned about?
Zeke is a lovely man. He's got nothing but love in his heart for this town. He didn't mean no harm. You know, being in jail changes a guy. I should know this. Yeah. I don't want that for Zeke. I don't want that for the town. He only meant the best. I spent half my life behind bars. What's 5 more years?
Hold on. Is that even possible?
I don't know what's possible anymore. All right. Deputy, release Zeke.
And take Mr. Ox to jail.
No! Leave Ox be! Leave them all be!
Send them.
Let's just call it even. That way we can get back to celebrating Founders Day. What do you think?
Hey, ring the bell!